2032. Rere Bay. So we're going in there and then to Rere Bay. This is Shark Island. There is clear passage in shore of it. Through the entrance to Stevenson Island. And looking up harbour to Whangaroa Township and Marina. We're going to Rere Bay, which is straight ahead of us.
There'll be a lot of boats at anchor, but we don't draw much, and it's high tide.
This is looking to the head of Pekapeka Bay. We were anchored there for lunch yesterday.
I never grow tired of this landscape.
We're anchored in Rere Bay. Up ahead is the way to the swimming hole, freshwater. There's a couple of private batches here. It's fairly shallow up the head of the bay. Not particularly a problem for us.
We've certainly got a high tide at the moment. It really is a high tide. You can get all the way up. Got to be careful of the rocks and the outboard props though. And the water will be cold, but that's no excuse not to go in. Here comes the crew. No squeals yet. Oh, here's Katie thinking the water's beautiful, and Lisa's got to almost belly button stage and given up. There you go, that wasn't so bad, was it?
Beautiful smile.
Here comes another paddleboard. Now we're warming up in the sunshine.
Sailing up the jib, we're heading for the water buoy to fill up, and then the plan is to head that way. So it's supposed to be 10 to 15 outside, probably on the nose knowing our luck, but we'll be heading for the Cavallis. Now that's a big cat, looks like they've done their washing. We're going to have a strong outgoing tide, so at the moment we're in the back eddy, but let up shortly. It doesn't look like there's a lot of wind up ahead, so the iron genoa may be pressed into service in short order. Starting to feel the tide now. We made it across, but there's not a lot of wind up here. Give it a little bit more, but I think the motor will definitely be started. Here's the water buoy. This boat's just finished. And there's a launch just appeared behind us.
Tanks on this port side of the boat. Shark Island to the left, Peach Island to the right.
Last view of the volcanic rock formations. There's Tauranga Bay.
Well, 38 minutes, current estimate from Arrow Rocks. To Flat Island, we have less than 5 knots of wind, so really not much point in doing anything apart from motoring. Bit of a untidy easterly swell as well. Here we have Flat Island, and behind it, Big Cavalli Island, and there's the island. Between Step Island and Vainland, and then behind that inner gap is Step Island.
Calming down now, we're in behind the Cavalli Islands.
Nahinipua, which is where we spent New Year's Eve, is up that way. None of the bays in here are shelter for this. sort of swell. We're about 20 minutes away from anchoring at our current 5 knots. There's Mahini Power in there. Cavalli Passage is that way. In here is Whangaroa Bay and the cap of the A-frame mast is one that was in a more sand getting painted in the big shed when we were there trying to paint our mast outside. We're heading for Home Bay, which is the next one over. This is Home Bay, big Cavalli Island. One year Finn and I climbed that ridge down the far side, jumped a stream, walked to the beach on the eastern side, and then came back on the, from here, left hand side of that gully, which was very tough going. More boats arriving. Wind dying, supposed to go southwest later. We've got Chief Sausage Cooker, Chief Salad Maker, sausages.